everywhere.
Welcome to another episode of On the Horizon Show, live on Facebook. I am so glad that you're joining me this evening. Did you make a cocktail? Yes, I did. Yeah. Thank you all from coast to coast to coast for watching tonight. And if you've missed any of the past shows, you can go to the Diversity in the Capital Facebook page or on YouTube, and you can search Mid Horizon. Tonight, like each Facebook Live, we will be checking in the conversation through the comments on Facebook Live and chime you in the conversation. So, speaking of which, I am going to do that right now and make sure that I am seeing you all live before I go on. There we are. All right. Okay, so before we go any further, I would like to take the time to remember. Right. So I'd like to take the time to remember a community member, WC Saga, who lost his life this morning. If you're ever, ever feeling alone, please reach out to me or someone you know. I will be there as much as I can and as often as I can. So you're never, ever, ever alone. So please contact me, or we can start a conversation and make sure that you've got what you need, or I can provide you with some resources. You're never alone, folks. I know this is a tough time right now, being in the during the pandemic and being secluded. Not everybody has a pet or a partner or somebody with them. So if you're feeling alone or lost, send Andre M. Prue a message or Ms. Horizon or even on the Diversity in the Capital Facebook page, and I'll be there. Right. Now, tonight's episode is our LGBTQ2 youth episode featuring the one and only Erik Bisson from Jeunesse IDEM, who are the only youth organization for LGBTQ for the Outaouais region. They are also working with Francophone LGBTQ youth in Ottawa. Their activities are mostly focused in Gatineau and the Outaouais region. And tonight, for the first time ever, my youngest guest, four-year-old Miss AJ, will be reading us a story. Or she'll be reading us. Not the way you think, folks. She's going to be reading us a story with her papa, Matt, and her daddy, who's going to be watching from all the way up north. We will also be discussing some hot topics, but some fun ones, keeping them light and fluffy, and taking some of your questions. So, now, I have to go to my trusty computer, and I have to do this. Hold on. It's really difficult being the person that you have to do everything. Unpin video. And now, AJ and her papa, Matt, how are you?
Hi. Say hi, AJ.
Well, so how are you both doing in this entire madness?
We're doing pretty good, AJ.
Yeah, the virus.
Yeah, the coronavirus, that's right. Yeah, AJ said today that the coronavirus was boring.
It's boring. Well,
we didn't get to have any fun.
Yeah, it's boring for all of us, AJ. Don't you worry. But at least you got Papa there to help you and play with you. Is he being a good Papa?
Yeah, but everyone's outside.
Yes, we go outside a lot. We ride our bike every day, get that sunshine when we can, right? Important to get outside.
Yeah, yeah, and get some sunshine.
Outside.
Well, it's supposed to be very nice this weekend.
Yes, AJ's playing to a beautiful sunset. We chose the spot here tonight because right around this time, the sun comes down.
Oh, well, that's wonderful.
That is a favorite time for a lot of parents right now during the pandemic. Bedtime is sacred.
Yes, and what you're going through is what a lot of parents are going through during this.
Yes, absolutely. But, you know, it's all about keeping them happy, keeping them fun, being creative, coming up with unique ideas to keep everybody sane, both them and me.
Did you pick your costume tonight, AJ, or did Papa pick it?
To give everybody a full tour of your beautiful outfit.
Oh, look at that.
This is regular bedtime attire around here.
Oh, okay. All right. Oh, you're wearing a feathered boa.
Papa, I'm always down for dress up and doing hair.
Oh, well, that's good. Well, you look beautiful, Miss AJ. So are you ready to read a book to us?
Yes, are we going to read our bedtime story tonight, AJ? Our book is called Love Makes a Family, because what makes a family, AJ?
Love.
Love. Okay, here, have a seat and help me read, all right? Mm-hmm. Okay, so we'll say.
Whoa, we're both on the camera.
Yeah. Love is waking up bright and early.
Uh-huh. That's love. Say love it. With it. What my cow?
Love is baking a special cake.
Yeah.
Can you turn the page?
Yeah.
This way. Love is knowing where everything is. You're going to come and help turn, AJ? Come on over here. Uh-huh. Here, you can help turn the page. Oh, sticky pages. There we go. Love is finding the biggest
puddles.
You like to jump in puddles, right?
Yeah, I like to jump in really big puddles.
You sure do.
Last day I found a really giant puddle.
Love is lending a helping hand.
Why is he swimming?
Oh, he's upset. He didn't catch a fish. Here, turn the page. Great job. Love is watching from the front row. Love is playing on the weekend, and it's the weekend now.
Yeah.
Are we going to play?
Uh-huh. Love is making everything better.
Love is making things better again. That's right. Flip.
Love is taking a bath.
Love is washing away the day, but that's right. Yes, taking a bath. Go ahead. Whoa. Good catch.
love is reading one more book.
Hey, good job. Hey, I don't think we're done yet. Oh, hold on. Good job.
Love is getting away monsters.
Chasing away the monsters. What do we chase away our monsters with at night?
Monster spray?
Monster spray. Two parts water, one part lavender drop.
Love is giving you a kiss.
Oh, a good night kiss before bed. Can I have a good night kiss? And she wiped it away. She does that every time.
Yeah.
Say good night.
Good night.
Says, whether you have one parent, two moms, two dads, a mom and a dad, or another wonderful caregiver, there's one thing that makes every family a family, and that's?
Love.
Love. Everybody say love, right, AJ?
That was wonderful. Thank you.
You can have a sip. She's having a little bit of warm milk at bedtime, you know.
Oh, that's nice.
Very nice.
So, AJ, I understand that your daddy is not able to be with you, but apparently he's watching. Is there something you want to say to daddy? What would you like to say to him?
I love you.
Blow him a kiss. Blow him a big kiss.
That's wonderful. Oh, so I also understand it's your birthday next week. Is that true?
That's my birthday.
Yeah, so you're just like one of my nieces. Well, you have to have a very quiet birthday, right?
Yeah.
But what we're going to do right now is we're going to sing you happy birthday right now, and I'm going to get everybody watching to scream at the top of their lungs to sing happy birthday to you. So are you ready, Papa? Are you going to sing with me? One, two, three. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear AJ. Happy birthday to you. Yay! And how old are you going to be?
Four.
Four? How many is that? Like this? One, two, three, four. There you go.
Three.
Excellent.
Yeah.
One, two, three, four.
So is there anything else that you want to tell anybody in Canada today?
Yeah.
What would you like to say?
Take care.
Take care.
Stay well. Wash your hands.
Well, that's amazing. That's great. Well, I thank you so much for being on the show. You are
a
little superstar.
Thank you for letting us join into the story time.
Oh, well, once Papa said that you guys had a great story, I had to ask you to come.
Yeah.
What's that?
All right. He says, play with your kids.
Yeah.
Stay home and play with your kids. That's right. All day long if you can.
You don't even.
Bye, guys.
Well, thank you. Have a great evening, and we'll talk to you soon. Thank you, AJ.
Say bye.
Bye.
See you later. All right. Well, thank you to Miss AJ. And for that amazing story, I hope they had fun reading it tonight. And I hope she keeps it up because, oh my God, was that ever cute. So, my next guest, Erik Bisson from Jeunesse IDEM, the director of Jeunesse IDEM. Jeunesse IDEM aims to improve the quality of life for gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender, transsexual, and questioning youth from 14 to 25 years old. and to raise awareness of the population of the Uduwa region. It is one of the organizations close to my heart, and I love this guy. Bonjour, Eric, comment ça va?
Bonsoir, André, ça va bien.
Oh, it's so great to have you. It's been a while since I've seen you.
I know. I wish we could have been closer, but, you know, the circumstances makes it a little harder, but I'm really happy that you invited me.
Oh, well, it's my pleasure. I mean, you know, I've been with Jeunesse IDEM for several years, and I was supposed to be at the last show with
that. We actually had to cancel because of the fabulous coronavirus, unfortunately, yes. But I'm sure we'll see you soon.
Yes. Oh, I'm sure we will. I'm sure we will. I'm going to change this to gallery view. There we go. So now, right. So I want to talk to you about the complications of the confinement, especially for the LGBTQ youth.
Definitely. Right now, because everybody is confined in their home and sometimes not necessarily with the people that they want, and especially right now, we're talking about more of the youth or people that are maybe a little bit more isolated, that they are alone and they're not comfortable with who they are as for their gender identity or their sexual orientation. And it's not necessarily that they're out or not out, but just being confined and not being able to be themselves and being comfortable around the people that they are with and being confined within those walls with their family. Sometimes it's a really, really hard time because they don't find they have anybody to talk to. And after a while, they need to talk to other people. They need to let it out. And they have a lot of mixed emotion, a lot of pressure from family and society as well. But, you know, finding themselves really lonely in those times is really particular. So that's why we try to keep in contact with our youth through internet, either with Facebook. We have a Hangout group as well. So a little social gathering, but with internet. On Hangout, and we also do the one-on-one counseling. So whenever people feel lonely and all that, every day from 3 to 4, we have our discussion group, but also they can reach us so we could have like somewhat of a meeting one-on-one on FaceTime or other, just to make sure that people have the support that they need.
That's great. I'm so glad you guys are still doing what you can. And, you know, there is issues with Zoom and everything, but this is my fourth week using Zoom, and we've been using it for my daytime job as well. And we had up to 20 people. And it was great because you got to see everybody. And it's been so long since you've seen anybody. So I highly suggest that you guys can use a whole Zoom thing. And if ever you need mine, then you let me know. You're welcome to use it. You can awesome. All have fun with it.
Awesome.
So, who is Jeunesse IDEM and what do you do? Type of services that you offer in these times of confinement?
Well, especially right now, it's a little harder because we cannot have people over at the office. Our office right now is closed, downtown hall, but we still offer one-on-one support through the internet. Excuse me. And over the phone, we could have a little meeting over the phone so we could talk. Sometimes just to hear the voice, as you said earlier, when we started the message, the intro, it's really important to feel that we're not alone. And then when we have all those bundle of emotion, we need to talk to someone. And that's why we try to be there. There's also a possibility to write us an email and we could do that. And there's always that support group because one-on-one is good, but to feel connected with other youth that are going through the same thing as you, or that has the same past or same kind of passage that you're going through right now, it is really nice and comforting to know that you're not alone in that. And just to talk about pretty much anything and everything, and just laughing, being sending pictures of funny things just makes us happy, changes our mood as well. So that's what we do basically right now. We're working basically to reorganize everything that we offer with stuff that we can do online, as workshops for doing prevention on homophobia and transphobia, and making sure that our professionals are aware of the situation and the, you know, particular things that LGBTQ youth can go through. So we're actually working on different workshops that we can offer through Zoom, Webinar, and all that kind of stuff. So we're working on that right now.
That's awesome. And I love that fact because this is the reason why I've been doing so much for your organization is because when I was a youth coming out of the closet in Narnia Circus, there wasn't anything like this available for me. So the only place I could go to meet other people was gay bars, really. Being a young man in Quebec, I was allowed to go to the bars at 18, but I wasn't allowed to go to the bars in Ontario. Wasn't allowed. But this is the moment I heard of Je ne sais dem, this is why I had to help out, because I really, really wish this would have existed when I was a youth, and I probably wouldn't have ended up where I am today. But I still don't regret anything I've ever done. But seriously, my hat's off to all of you and all the folks that work in Je ne sais dem for keeping this going for the kids, for my nieces. My three nieces are watching. Hi, girls. So, you know, them and their friends, they're going to need this place when any kid, you know, I love it.
We were lucky enough to have you around for a little over 2 years to do, basically you were the head of Je ne sais dem as promoting the organization, making sure that people knew who we were. You put us on the map a lot more than what we already had. And you made such a difference working with our youth, not necessarily because you were doing fundraising shows in bars, which was at Le Petit Chicago and Le Minotaur, which are really open-minded bars and establishments, really open, crew over there. And you made such a difference because every time that you had a chance, and you still do talk about Je ne sais dem and the importance of talking to others, knowing the organization, and feeling better about themselves. And I remember last year, almost like a month from now, when we were at Queer Spirit Expo, you suggested to, oh, I want to do a show, but I want Je ne sais dem to be with me. So everybody learned and practiced a nice choreography with you. And we made a blast at the Queer Spirit Expo, but it did change the lives of all those kids. Some of those never actually been in public out and being proud of who they were. So there was like all that, you know, all those rainbow all over the place. Oh, and you made that possible.
Well, yes. And it was my pleasure too. I mean, I kept telling the organizer who I had on the show last week, Jesse Reynolds, saying, you know, we're working on an epic production. Because of having a booth, I was allowed 15 minutes of stage time. And I was like, you know what? Erik, let's get something together with the kids. And I'm so glad. There was a good 20-some kids.
You what? Yep. Yeah, with me. I don't count as a kid, but hey.
Oh, my God. You and I still keep watching that video, which I actually could probably show the video right now.
It still runs on YouTube.
Yes, it does. It is still on YouTube. And I could not stop watching it. I still can't. I watched it a couple of days ago, and I actually thought of doing that song again tonight. But you know what? If I would have sorted that out a little better, I could have showed the video.
But that's okay. I'm pretty sure, you know, all the viewers today are going to be curious enough, if they haven't seen it already, go and watch it right after the show.
So you can search Ms. Horizon, MZ Horizon on YouTube, Queer Sphere Expo, and you'll see the video. And it was from The Greatest Showman, This Is Me, with the 20 kids. So when we rehearsed it that morning, I remember, because it was the Sunday morning of my birthday, June 9th.
Yep.
And we rehearsed it, and that's when the organizers saw the production, and they had no idea that that was coming. And how many times did we have to perform it that day? Twice. Yes. And My heart.
Originally, it was once.
Yeah.
Originally, it was once, but people like it so much, they want the kids to do it again.
Oh, and you know what? You know what, Erik? I'm going to show it. Because I can. We have time. We have lots of time. So I'm going to show the video. I'm going to find it first. Is there anything that you want to talk about while I'm searching for this?
Well, just the fact of having you, Horizon, with us made a big difference, as I said. But also to be able to be so generous and making sure that people knew who we were. But at the same time, is we know it's not all about money. But we also know that nonprofit organization, it is rough. It is tough to find money and grants to be able to pay the rent, pay the employees, making all kinds of activities, because all of our kids cannot always afford all the activities, summer camp, different monthly activities as well, just yep. to make sure that we can help those kids to be able to go to those activities. So in the last 2 years, we did raise with you almost a little over $17,000. So, which is really awesome. So you made it great, and you opened the door for a whole new world.
Hey, I do what I can, and it's because I love the community and I love all of you. So just a little warning to everybody that I'm about to play this video. Facebook may block out the sound when this, if you're rewatching this and you're not one of the live people watching this, which how many people are we up to? Well, we've got a good 13 people. So ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, here is Jeunesse Sidem at Queer Sphere Expo.
I still have all the shivers.
Yes, and it was yes. really good to hear. Hold on. It was good to hear all the people.
But at the same time, I'm sure that the viewers, if they go and see it on YouTube, the quality is a lot better.
Yeah, it's a little better, but it's still even my, as I'm watching it live, it wasn't the best quality. And unfortunately, we did not get a good quality of that, but you know what? The thought is there and the kids are there. It was their first time performing for a lot of them. Unfortunately, Queer Sphere Expo is not happening this year. They had to postpone it just like everything else in the city. So Queer Sphere 2021, look out for it. You can search them on Facebook at Queer Sphere on Facebook. And I think they're on Instagram as well. Which is going to be happening at the Aberdeen Pavilion this year, next year, Lansdowne Park. So it's a completely different venue. So, hey, I already have my booth booked, so we could talk.
Seriously. Oh, for sure. We're all in. Always.
Better production than last year. We can even get La Doresse in there too, and
yes,
we can do a duet with the kids. Like,
yeah, our new host, La Doris, that had, you know, she was one of our guests when you were our hostess, and right now she's wanted to take over as for, you know, you getting involved with other project and all that, and she wanted to you know, continue all the work that you've been doing. Unfortunately, we didn't have enough time because as soon as she started again the shows, then we had to cancel everything. And I'm sure though that you know, all the viewers will be able to get to know La Doris, which is an extraordinary artist from Montreal. We're actually working on maybe doing a little something. I have some little surprises for her.
Okay.
And some projects, so maybe you'll hear about it in the next couple of weeks, because we want to make sure that we can actually show to our kids that we're still there, despite the fact that we cannot be one-on-one and we cannot do you know, activities at our location, downtown hall, but that we can actually have fun and see each other through technology. So we're planning or working on something with La Doris from Montreal that is missing us, and we miss her as well. And I know that you two got along very, very well.
We did.
She has big shoes to fill, though, with Horizon here in the Ottawa region.
Yes. Well, I had her maybe 4 times, I think, or 5 yeah. times within the 2 years. And she also did the Gay Franco and Fat with me as well. And my favorite song she does is Banana Phone. Oh my God, that's hilarious. But when I had to stop doing the shows, it's because I just found out of my diagnosis. So I was very, you guys made me cry. My mascara ran that night and everything.
You still have your flower?
What's that?
You still have your rainbow flower?
Yes.
In the dome?
Oh, yes.
Every time I see one, I think of you.
I have two. The first one I was given was from work for my 40th birthday. And then the one you guys gave me last year. Last year. Last try.
Yep.
It's still here. Yes, it's here.
Awesome.
Yeah. I polish it every once in a while. It's in the front entrance, I believe. Yeah. Yeah, I do. So how can people reach you to participate and get involved or by donating to the organization?
Yeah, of course, right now we're really more reachable through our Facebook page, our Instagram. We're actually going to be putting up our website in the next couple of days as well. So just, you know, Facebook, Instagram, Jeunesse Idem. You can talk to us, you can ask us questions, and you can all see everything that we offer as for social activities, one-on-one counseling, discussion group for trans people, for 23 to 35, 14, 25. We also have a support group for our parents as well that have LGBTQ kids. So they need the support as well. We do a lot of prevention, a lot of workshops as well in schools, high school. Next year, we're gonna be starting, if school starts again, we will be in our elementary school as well with the books, trying to learn about, you know, gay culture and to get the kids ready to go from elementary to high school, and, you know, being able to be more prepared about bullying, homophobia, and transphobia, and trying to educate the teachers and all the people in both school, elementary and high school. So we're working really, really hard, but the sad part is we're only 2 full-time employees.
Yeah, you're only down to 2. There's you and who now?
Well, there's us, about me as the general director. We have Alex, our nice Alex, that is with me on the video that we just saw with
the
football hat. Yeah, which is our counselor with the youth there. There's also Nicola that works a lot on our webpage, Facebook, Instagram, all the activity and events. He's our planner. So he's going to be with us throughout the summer. He's working a lot right now on the side. We have Caroline.
And he's going to be a heartbreaker when he gets older, too.
Oh, don't talk to me about that right now. Let's, you know, one day at a time. And we also have Caroline, which is the nice, lovely face that you see when you get inside the building when you get to see a Jeunesse Dame. And we have Jeremy, that is our graphic designer. So everything that is graphic design, he's the one working with that. But some of them are just, you know, part-time, 16, 20 hours a week. Yep. Some on program volunteers. And we also had Alex, which was with us as a co-op student from l'Université du Québec en Ottawa in social work.
Okay.
So we had a big team, but we're only two full-time employees. So we have to get a little bit more stuff happening. So if people want to get involved, being a volunteer, knowing what we want, they need support, they can also go and donation to for a kid to participate as a summer camp or whatever. They can also do that online as canadon.org or donate.org.
Yeah. So, and then don't you have a donate button on your Facebook page as well?
Always.
Yeah. So you
click on the button.
And see them Facebook page to donate.
Yep.
So I've got a few comments here that I'm seeing. So a gentleman named Patrick McCann. Woohoo! Awesome show, chills and goosebumps.
You can say it. He's my boyfriend. He's just he's my fan, number one fan.
Is he behind the camera there somewhere?
No, he's hiding.
Oh, okay.
In our small little studio.
All right. He loves you to the moon and back. Thank you for everything you do for all. My boss, Valentina, merci de m'avoir fait découvrir Jeunesse Idem. Alex Le, who was AJ's dad. I love you too, sweetheart. Oh, I'm sorry, Alex, that I didn't get that to her on time. As well, John Milkey, sounding good. Queers for Expo, all excited that we were talking about them. My mom, hello, Uncle Andy. Happy birthday to AJ. Happy birthday from John Milkey. François Zaraga, happy birthday. José Rollin, salut, Eric. François Zaraga, bonjour, Eric. Amazing work from Valentina and François, Mrs. Kerr, but I'm assuming it's La Dore she's talking about because I've been talking to her often. We're working on a benefit for the transgender community because their medications are not being covered and a lot of them can't afford it. So keep your ears to the ground. Mm-hmm. There's a big benefit coming. It's going to be a karaoke, well, not karaoke style, it's a sing. Live singing show that's coming up, but it has nothing to do with my cancer event that's still happening on June 6th. It will be online, so we're still working on that.
Awesome. André, or Horizon, sorry. when you were talking about the trans people, I'm totally touched by the fact that you want to do something for the trans community because they're struggling, and especially right now, because a lot of them got a call from their doctors or surgeons saying, we have to postpone your surgeries.
Yes.
And these moments are so crucial because they've been marking the calendar and saying, it's, you know, in 10 days.
And they've been counting the days too, I can understand.
Yeah, and now they have to struggle with their gender dysphoria because of, you know, those events. So we're really trying to be there for them and support them. And, you know, whenever we see things going on, because right now everybody's on Facebook, our thumbs are like so sore because everybody's scrolling and seeing all kinds of stuff. But don't be afraid of, you know, sharing things about, you know, people that are within the GLBT community or anything that touches people that can actually help them, support them and comfort them. So because that is something good as much as you can just say hello or just send a smile, but people need to feel that they're not alone and that it will get better.
Yes, it will. And that's all going to be thanks to François Zaraga, who is actually working on the benefit. So I said I was only going to do one benefit this year, and that was my cancer benefit. So now I'm doing two, which is fine. I have no problem. I will support everybody as much as I can. And I love the community, as you can tell. I do what I can. I do what I can. So let's get into
You do it so topic. Well.
What's that?
And you do it so well.
Ah, merci, Minou. All right. So is there a favorite movie that you and Patrick have watched?
We've watched so many. But now that we saw that little video, I think we will watch The Greatest Showman again.
Right. Because
that is just the goosebump and all the music pumping. That's a fantastic movie. So maybe we'll sit down and cuddle and watch that movie soon.
Yeah, I almost did pink tonight too, but I really don't like the pink hair I have. And I used to use my own hair, but I can't. So yeah, I love that movie. I think that's a good idea, actually. I might watch that again too.
Oh, yes.
Have you guys had a very romantic night?
As tonight?
Any night. No, not tonight.
Well, you know, we're in the really, really small studio. It's like a 20-some by 30-some. So it's really, really short. But we did pass our test, 6 weeks together.
Uh-huh.
All the time, not an arguing, you know, no arguments, no nothing. We still love each other, and we do a lot of video games, board games, some reading, but I also do a lot of work from home because we need to be there, and we still have a lot of administration to do. But we do find a lot of time to sit down, laugh, and cuddle, and watch a nice movie on Netflix or any other platform that we can find.
Yeah, well, Amazon has a lot of great movies. If you haven't watched the Jason Momoa SEE, if you like Game of Thrones, you're gonna love that. Guaranteed. Like, we watched the entire season in two nights.
Wow.
So yeah, there's quite a few good series that are happening right now. So yeah, hit me up. I'll give you a couple of good ones.
Oh, there you go. We'll call each other.
Yeah, for sure. All right. Well, I mean, I'm going to thank you right now because I'm going to work on a little performance and then we're going to end it off. But I want to thank you so much for once again dropping your hat or your tie or whatever you've dropped to come and talk with me this evening. I'm very glad that I'm bringing a new awareness once again to Jeunesse Idem. Because even though we're all confined, there's still people and places out there to help you. And that's why I wanted to make sure.
People need to spread the word as well to make sure that the people have somebody to talk to. And there is also Interling, which is 24/7 for any time. You could chat, you could talk, you could text if you feel lonely. Never be alone with all the emotion and whatever you struggle. And they also open the lines for people that are within the GLBT community, but the elderly people as well, because they do feel lonely sometimes. So we have to make sure to be there for them. And thank you to you to invite me to always think of Jeunesse Idem and all their the youth that are there, that are growing and being a part of changing the world for a better place. So thank you for being there for us within the community.
Oh, I'm a mix of the Canadian, Kelly Clarkson, and Ellen right now. So
there you go.
You know what? We've got over 600 people that watch and follow Diversity in the Capital. So I am thankful for everybody else allowing me to do this. And you know what? It's taken a lot out of my mind too. So I have fun doing this every week, and to have you, my God, my hat's off. Thank you so much for being here. Very much. So if you want, you can go or you can stay. It's up to you. And you can do a little bit of dancing as well, because, I'm going to be doing a little dance. So I also want to thank, See, Horizon can't wear her glasses tonight because of these beautiful eyelashes that everybody keeps commenting on. I wish you all the love and goodness during this time and look forward to seeing what you both have got going on social media. Erik, make sure you tag me on anything that you've got coming up. I would love to share it. So next week, I will be talking about one-person shows, and I have two amazing guests. My first one is an amazing producer of the Jesse and Jenna Messy podcast. He's a radio host for many years here in Ottawa-Gatineau, and now is the main man for blasttheradio.com, which I've been listening to every morning in my beautiful little studio that becomes my office during the day for work. On blasttheradio.com, it's the one and only John the Milkman Milky, and my second guest. Now, she is the queen of Puerto Vallarta, and her one-woman show is taking the world by storm. She's been to Puerto Vallarta, she's been to San Francisco, she's been to many, many, many places all around the world, and her Facebook Live last week had over 20,000 views. Love her. And I was so proud to be able to sing with her 10 years ago in a little trio with my mammy, Steve Roslin, which was Three's Company Cabaret. I am so excited to have her next week. Miss Conception is here with me next week as well. So it's all talking about one man and woman shows. So I am looking so forward to that. But now it has come time to the part of the show. Well, we have a little music. We had a little bit of music earlier, which hopefully you kept going if the sound cut out. But this will all be available on YouTube, so you're welcome to go and check it out. Nothing will be silenced, knock on wood, on that. So without further ado, Horizon is going to have you dancing a little bit. So the Blast the Radio has a little bit of boogie break. Well, we have a little bit of parquet. Of the show. So let me just get my song and here we go. I hope you enjoy it.
Think about it. There must be a higher love down in the heart or hidden in the stars above. Without it, life is a wasted time. Look inside your heart and I look inside mine. Things look so bad everywhere. In this whole world, what is fair? We walk the line and try to see. Falling behind what could be. Oh, oh, bring me a higher love. Bring me a higher. Bring me a higher love. Where's that higher love? I keep thinking of that,
I keep thinking of
Thank you, Ottawa Gatineau. I hope you have a great weekend. Stay home, stay safe, stay the blazing home. Come on now. I love you all. I hope you all have a
icy
great,
hot. Rise great from pain.
Weekend.
I see the doll.
There we go. So have a great weekend. Once again, Misconception next weekend, and the one and only John, the Milkman Milky. I love you. See you later, baby. All right, let's eat. Have a good night. Thank you.